Deuteronomy chapter 34.
生命记34章.
Verse 1 through verse 6. Then Moses climbed Mount Nebo from the plains of Moab to the top of Pisgah across from Jericho. There the Lord showed him the whole land from Gilead to Dan, all of the Naphtali, the territory of Ephraim and Manasseh, all the land of Judah as far as the western sea, the Negev, and the whole region from the valley of Jericho, the city of palms, as far as Zoar. Then the Lord said to him, "This is the land I promised on oath to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob when I said, 'I will give it to your descendants.' I have let you see it with your eyes, but you will not cross over into it." And Moses, the servant of the Lord, died there in Moab, as the Lord had said. He, God, buried him, Moses, in Moab, in the valley opposite Beth Peor. But to this day, no one knows where his grave is.
摩西从摩崖平原登尼伯山，上了那与耶利哥相对的比斯加山顶。耶和华把基列全地，直到但、拿弗他利全地、以法莲、马拿西地。 犹大全地，直到西海，南地和棕树城耶利哥的平原，直到索尔，都指给他看。耶和华对他说：“这就是我向亚伯拉罕、以撒、雅各起誓应许之地，说我必将这地赐给你的后裔。现在我使你眼睛看见了，你却不得过到那里去。”于是耶和华的仆人摩西死在摩崖地，正如耶和华所说的。耶和华将他埋葬在摩崖地。 伯比尔对面的谷中，只是到今日，没有人知道他的坟墓。Some
of you may be asking, Pastor Nate, how did Moses write the last chapter of the book of Deuteronomy, which talks about his own death?
也许有人会问说，内德牧师，摩西他怎么写的最后一章？因为他那时候已经死了。Almost
all scholars, almost universally, understand that Moses would have written everything up until now.
所有的圣经学者都认为，摩西从写了前五本书一直到现在。
And that very likely, quite possibly, Joshua would have written the last chapter of the book of Deuteronomy.
非常有可能的就是约书亚写了《生命记》的最后一章。
Because Moses has come to die.
因为摩西那时候要死了。
Some of you might be thinking or asking, Pastor Nate, why are you talking about death again?
有人也许会问，你为什么又在讲关于死的事？
For two reasons. One, because death is part of your life.
两个原因，第一，死是生命当中不可避免的。
And I must preach the entirety of human life.
所以我要针对人的生命来讲。
But most importantly, because the text talks about Moses' death.
更重要的是，圣经讲到摩西的死。
We will preach the text.
我们是根据圣经来讲道。
We know that Moses was born as a slave, a child of slaves in the foreign land of Egypt.
我们知道摩西是一个奴隶所生的孩子，是生在一个异国他乡的埃及地。
And through the protection of the Lord God Himself, he was raised in the palace.
因为神的保护，实际上他是在皇宫里长大。
And even though he was raised in the palace of the Pharaohs, he did not become like them.
虽然他是在法老的宫中长大，但是他没有变成他们的样式。
God had called Moses to serve him.
神呼召他来服侍他。
To follow him.
来跟随他。
And to lead him.
来带领他。
And as a man, as a shepherd, Moses obeyed his Lord. And so he said to Pharaoh, on behalf of his master, let my people go.
作为一个牧人，作为一个仆人，摩西对法老说， 请容我的百姓去。
Most of you know the stories of Moses' life.
大家都知道摩西的一生。
He wandered the desert for 40 years, leading the Israelites, but because of their gross sin, a journey that could have taken a week took 4 decades.
摩西在旷野带领以色列人走了40年，实际上只有一个礼拜的路程，因为他们的罪的缘故。
Let that be your application for today.
今天我们也可以应用这一点。
Let the journey that should have taken a week that took 40 years, let that be your application today.
一个只有一周就可以完成的旅途，却花了40多年。
Get alone in your secret place and with your secret heart between you and your God. Ask him, Lord, what has taken me 40 years that you wanted me to be able to do in a week?
你可以在建藏你心中的隐秘来到主面前问他说，主啊，为什么你让我一个礼拜做的事情，我却花了40年？
Lord, what could obedience have brought me that my disobedience has cost me?
主啊，向我显明我的这些不顺服带来的结果是什么样？
And Moses was a man.
摩西是一个人,
a man.
他是一个男子汉,
just like you.
正如你一样,
just like me.
就正如我一样,
just human.
他只是一个人,
doubted.
他也怀疑过,
got angry.
也发怒过,
scared.
他也害怕过,
he was a quitter at times.
他也曾经放弃过,
didn't want to do what the Lord called him to.
他不需要做神所呼召他所做,
he had highs, he had lows.
他有高潮也有低谷,
he's just a man.
他只是一个人,
just a man.
他只是一个人,
we must not make him something he was not, something greater than he was.
我们不应该把他看作高于他所示的,
he was born, he lived.
他出生, 他也活过,
he raised children.
他也抚养过孩子,
he led the people of God as God's shepherd for the Israelites.
他也带领,作为牧人带领神的子民,
he wrote the books, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy.
他也写了创世纪,出埃及记,申命记,民数记和生命记。
And then he was led by his God, his maker, his master, his king into the desert to die.
他的神,他的主人所 创造他的主带进了这个沙漠地荒漠。
I'm always fascinated by the titles of God in the Bible.
我对神对自己的称呼是常常非常的。
I've told the teenagers that they should begin to pray and meditate over the names and titles of God in the Bible.
我跟我们这些年轻的孩子们都讲说，你们要开始思想神的名字。
I tell you as a church this morning, you should begin to pray and meditate over the names and the titles of God.
作为全教会，我们也应该去来思想神,
King, Master, Savior,
神的名字, 祂是君王,
Shepherd, Lord, Potter,
主人救主, 窑匠,
Door, Gate, Bread, Life,
是门是, 生命是生命的粮,
Water and Rock.
水和磐石。
Once and only once in the Bible that I know of,
在生命当中, 据我所知, 只有一次,
God was a grave digger.
神, 后悔了。
Once and only once that I know of,
只有一次, 神后悔了。
did God bury a man.
神, 只有一次, 神亲自埋葬了一个人。
And that man was Moses.
那个人就是摩西。
All men who live, they die.
所有活过的人都死了。
All men.
所有的人。
The Bible tells us that there were two men who have not yet faced death.
圣经也告诉我们有两个人没有经历过死。
Enoch and Elijah.
就是以诺和以利亚。
I am convinced, as many are in the book of Revelation, that even they meet death.
我跟大家, 我相信都一样, 即使他们也最后也要死亡, 就是在启示录里所讲的。
That's a story for another day.
那个我们另外找个时间再讲。
All men are born.
所有的人,
all men die.
出生, 死亡。
This was true for Moses.
摩西也一样。
This was even true for the Lord himself, the Lord Jesus Christ.
甚至主耶稣也经历了同样的。
God the Father who did not spare his only son.
神没有留下自己的儿子不赐给我们。
But who died not just for himself, but for the sins of all mankind.
他是为人所有人类的罪而死。
And you.
也包括你。
You will die.
你也会死。
You will die.
你也会死。
And so many of us try to deny that reality.
但是很多人都想否认这个现实。
Oh, if I just went to the doctor more, I wouldn't die.
如果多去看医生，我就不会死。
If you go to the doctor more, you may not die for a season.
你去看医生多，也许你一段时间不会死。
Amen. We've got doctors in this room. If you go to a doctor, you may not die for a season.
我们这里边就有医生，你去看医生，也许暂时不会死。
But I bet they amend me when I say you will die.
但是我相信，当我说你会死的时候，他们也会说阿门。
I didn't get the amens I wanted on it.
但是我没有听到。
Because they're fearful of their own death.
他们也怕自己要死。
Just like.
就像我们一样。
But will you bow the knee before you die?
在你死之前，你愿不愿谦卑跪下来？
When you meet your maker, will you smile or will you cry?
当你见到你的创造你的人，你的主的时候，你是会哭呢，还是会笑呢？
Will you accept it with grace and with mercy, or will you be angry and fearful?
你是因着他的恩典，他的怜悯被接纳呢，还是因为他会
笑？ Moses, this was a journey that he was ready to take.
对于摩西来说，这是一个生命的旅程。
For Moses, this was his opportunity not to go into the promised land.
对于摩西，这个时候他却进不了迦南地，应许之地。
The promised land is special because God said that it was special.
应许之地是非常特别的，因为神这样说过。
The promised land is just a place.
应许之地只是一个地方。
Person, place, thing. Definitions of nouns.
就是人、地方还有东西。
What's better than a place?
比一个地方更好的是什么呢？
Person.
就是人。
Amen?
嗯。
And who walked with Moses?
谁和摩西同行？
Who walked with him as he died?
当他死的时候，谁和他同
行？ Who willingly took the body?
谁把他的尸体埋葬呢？
God, the burial. God, the grave digger.
神为他挖了坟墓。
It is said that all men live two lives.
有句话说人，所有的人都有两个生命。
I want you to raise your hand if you've heard this. It is said that all men live two lives.
所有的人都过了两种人生。
The second one begins when they realize they only have one life.
第二个人生开始，当他遇见他知道自己只有一个人生的时候，他才开始第二个人生。
Raise your hand if you've heard that.
大家听过这个的，请举手。
All men have two lives.
所有的人都有两种人生。
Second one begins when you realize you only have one.
只有意识到他只有一个人生的时候，开始第二个人生。
How old was Moses when God called him to lead his people?
摩西当时呼召他的时候，呼召他带领他子民的时候，他是多大岁数？
I heard 80. I heard. I'll take anything from 70 to 90. Do I hear 100?
那个七十九十。
When he was called. 80.
他是八十岁，当八十岁被神呼召带领他的百姓。
How old was Moses when he died?
他死的时候多大了？
120.
120岁。
Amen. Some of you are not yet 80.
大家大部分都还没有到八十岁。
But I don't believe you will live to 120.
但是我不相信你们能活到120岁。
You should get to living. You should start living.
你应该开始真正的生活。
Amen? Amen? Start following.
开始跟随。
Start bending the knee.
开始屈下你的膝。
And we're not promised tomorrow.
但是因为我们没有保证明天。
We're not promised this afternoon.
甚至今天下午都没有保证。
Moses understood that because he was a servant.
摩西明白这一点，因为他是一个仆人。
Let's look at verses 10 through 12.
那我们看十到十二节。
Secondly, we understand there was no prophet like Moses.
第二点就是我们知道没有先知像摩西一样。
Verses 10 through 12. Since then, no prophet has risen in Israel like Moses, whom the Lord knew face to face.Who did all those miraculous signs and wonders the Lord sent him to do in Egypt, to Pharaoh and to all his officials and to his whole land? For no one has ever shown the mighty power or performed with awesome deeds that Moses did in the sight of all Israel.
第十节，以后以色列中再没有兴起先知像摩西的，他是耶和华面对面所认识的。耶和华打发他在埃及地向法老和他的一切臣仆，并他的全地行各样神迹奇事，又在以色列众人眼前显大能的手，行一切大而可畏的事。
The Bible makes it clear in both the Old and the New Testaments that Moses had no equal.
圣经讲得很清楚，不管是旧约还是新约，是没有大过摩西的。
There was never another prophet that matched what Moses was able to do.
没有任何一个先知能够与摩西相比，能做他所做的事。
And not just as prophet, but as prophet, priest, pastor, shepherd.
不单单是先知，而且是祭司，也是牧师，也是牧人。
We should celebrate that this morning. I do.
我们应该庆祝这一点。
I celebrate the servant Moses.
我向摩西庆祝他是一个仆人的。
The Bible is full of books of prophecy.
圣经充满了先知性的书籍。
There are dozens of prophets in the Bible named.
大概有很多的先知书都是有名字的。
My favorite prophet Isaiah.
我所喜非常喜欢的就是以赛亚这位。
Was not equal to Moses.
但是他也没有与摩西不能。
Isaiah is my favorite.
我很喜欢以赛亚。
You should read the Gospel of Isaiah.
你应该读以赛亚书。
Powerful, powerful prophetic book of the Bible.
是圣经当中非常有力的这个。
But I believe that Isaiah was not Moses's equal.
但是我也相信以赛亚跟摩西是不能相比的。
My father's name was Amos.
我父亲的名字叫阿摩斯。
My name is Nathan.
我的名字叫。
Even though I tell you it's Nate.
Nathan, there's a name in Chinese.
My firstborn son's name is, excuse me, my secondborn son's name is Micah.
我的二儿子名叫弥迦。
Amos, Nathan, Micah. Not as great as Moses.
哦，拿孙和弥迦都不能与摩西相比。
Amen.
Amen.
The Bible makes it clear.
圣经讲得非常清楚。
No one was Moses his equal.
没有人能够与摩西相比。
But the Bible also makes it clear.
圣经也同时讲得很清楚。
Moses had one superior.
摩西有一个人是超越摩西。
One prophet. Who was greater than Moses?
有一个先知是大于摩西的。
One priest who was greater than Moses.
一个祭司是大于摩西的。
One shepherd who was greater than Moses.
一个牧人是大于摩西的。
One king who was a greater leader than Moses.
一位君王他是大过摩西的。
One servant who was greater than Moses.
有一位仆人是大过摩西的。
One sacrifice.That was greater than all the sacrifices that Moses led in the desert.
有一个祭物是大过所有摩西在旷野所献的一切祭物。
Oh, church. Church. Say his name.
大家知道这个人是谁吗？
Amen.
是耶稣基督。
Amen.
Amen.
One who was greater than
Moses. 只有一位大过摩西的。
Jesus Christ, the Son of God, was and is and forever shall be eternal God.
耶稣基督是过去、现在、一次、将来，永远是神。
God the Father is eternal.
父神是永恒的。
God the Son is eternal.
圣子也是永恒的。
God the Holy Spirit is eternal.
圣灵也是永恒的。
And behold, there is but one God.
只有一位神。
This is the truth of Christianity.
这就是基督信仰的。
This is what we hold.
这就是我们所持。
This is what binds us.
这就是带领我们在一起。
This is what saves us.
这就是拯救我们的原因。
And then God the Son became human.
然后神的儿子变成了人。
Became a man.
变成一个人。
He was born.
他出生了。
Interestingly, there were many similarities between the birth of Christ and the birth of Moses.
很有趣的是，摩西的出生和耶稣的出生有很多相似之处。
Many distinctions as well.
当然有很多的不同。
I encourage you to study that.
我鼓励大家仔细去查考。
There had never been a prophet like Moses.
没有先知大过摩西。
So the Bible tells us.
所以圣经是这样讲的。
Every leader in Christianity falls short.
所有基督的领袖们，他们都亏缺了神的荣耀。
We should honor him more than we do.
我们应当去尊敬他。
What an incredible servant of God.
他是神的一个伟大的仆人。
But Moses would say that if he were here.
如果摩西在这里，他会这样讲。
Was one who was greater.
他说有一位。
One who was greater.
有一位大过我的。
The Lord God.
就是神。
The Lord God.
耶和华神。
The Lord God.
耶和华神。
That's what Moses would say were he here.
如果他在这里，他会这样。
Give your life to the Creator.
把你的生命献给造。
Give your life to your King.
把你的生命给你的君。
Give your life to the Lord who alone can save.
把你生命献给主，只有他能够拯救。
That's what Moses would say.
摩西应该会这样讲。
Then finally, we see this morning that the servant leader met the servant master.
最后一点就是这位摩西式的仆人，遇到了，仆人式的主。
Verses, excuse me, Luke chapter 9, I encourage you to turn there in your Bibles.
鼓励大家翻到路加福音第九章。
We'll read just a few verses, verses 28 to 32.
我们来读28到32节，路加福音第九章。
When the servant leader met the servant master.
这位仆人的领袖遇到了仆人的主。
At about 8 days after Jesus said this, he took Peter, John, and James with him and went up onto a mountain to pray. As he was praying, the appearance of his face changed, and his clothes became as bright as a flash of lightning. Two men, Moses and Elijah, appeared in glorious splendor, talking with Jesus. They spoke about his departure, which he was about to bring to fulfillment at Jerusalem. Peter and his companions were very sleepy, but when they became fully awake, they saw his glory and the two men standing with him.
说了这话以后，约有八天，摩西带着彼得、约翰、雅各上山去祷告。正祷告的时候，他的面貌就改变了，衣服洁白放光。忽然有摩西、以利亚两个人同耶稣说话，他们在荣光里显现，谈论耶稣去世的事，就是他在耶路撒冷将要成就的事。彼得和他的同伴都打盹，记忆清醒了，就看见耶稣的荣光，并同他站着的那两个人。
Historically, the church has called this story the Transfiguration of Christ.
教会把这段故事叫做耶稣基督的登山变相。
It's the moment late in Christ's ministry when Jesus reveals his full glory to his disciples and to two other men.
就在耶稣在地上侍奉的快要结束的时候，他把他自己的荣耀向他的两个门徒显现。
Jesus is living in the last year of his human life.
他是作为人他在地上的最后一年。
He has experienced two public Passovers, the Gospels tell us, and he will only experience one more, and on the next day he will be crucified and killed.
圣经告诉我们，他已经在地上过了两个逾越节。就是最后一个逾越节的时候，他就要被钉死。
He will soon, the scriptures tell us, set his face towards Jerusalem.
他就很快就会把他的要面向耶路撒冷。
And he will not turn back.
他不会再回头了。
If there is anyone who can fully, or not fully, if there's anyone who can understand some of what Jesus is approaching, it is Moses and Elijah.
如果能够明白耶稣他要所面对的事情的时候，只有以利亚和摩西。
We actually have the stories of both of these men at the very end of their ministries, one in Deuteronomy 34, the other in 2 Samuel.
实际上这两位我们知道他们在地上侍奉最后的时候，一个是在这个生命记，另外一个在撒母耳记下讲到。
For Elijah, it was a moment of doubt and of severe constriction where he did not know where his hope came from.
以利亚也有这个时刻，就是他怀疑，他不知道自己的盼望从哪里来。
Elijah was confused and tired and pouting and depressed.
以利亚当时就是非常的低迷。
The Lord came to him.
神来到他那里。
Spoke to him.
向他讲话，
encouraged him.
鼓励他。
Moses, we understand his story.
摩西一样，我知道他的故事。
The Lord gathered him in that valley.
神在那个山谷当中来。
So here we see Jesus.
这里我们看耶稣基督。
Months before his death.
在他离世前几个月。
We see these two faithful servants, and we see their one sinless master.
我们看到他两个忠实的仆人，以及这位没有罪的主。
And let us consider that in Jesus' deity, in his divine nature, Jesus stands alone.
从耶稣角度，耶稣的神性的角度来讲，他自己，他独自在那里。
Jesus alone of all men, he is holy, he alone can save.
耶稣只有他自己是圣洁的，只有他可以救赎。
In verse 35, God the Father will declare it yet again.
在三十五节，父神要宣告。
So we see Jesus transfigured and these five earthly servants getting to see the glory of God in bodily form.
当耶稣登山变相的时候，有五位他的仆人看到他的在用肉身显现的荣耀。
And for Moses, this is not his first experience with the glorified God.
对于摩西来说，这不是第一次他所看到的荣耀的神。
Moses has experienced the glory of God many, many times.
摩西已经经历了神的荣耀很多次了。
Regularly.
经常的。
Frequently.
非常频繁的。
Intimately.
而且是非常亲密的。
And here once more.
这个地方又一次记述了他，与神亲密的接触。
I'm actually, I won't say that this morning. What does Luke tell us about this meeting? Look at verse 30.
路加告诉我们这一个会面的情形是什么呢？再我们来看三十节。
Verse 30 says, they, Jesus, Moses, and Elijah, they spoke about Jesus' departure.
三十一节他们在讲论耶稣去世的事。
What would Moses have been able to add to that conversation?
摩西在这个对话当中会讲些什么呢？
Did Moses bring comfort to the Lord Jesus Christ before Jesus' own death?
摩西难道会安慰在耶稣去世之前来安慰他吗？
Jesus knows all things.
耶稣知道所有的。
Jesus has all knowledge.
他有一切的知识。
Jesus had never physically died himself.
但是他自己还从来没有。
That was months away.
亲身体验死亡。
Was Moses in these last moments able to comfort his Lord?
摩西在这个最后的时刻能够安慰他的主吗？
I don't know.
我不太清楚。
Did Moses just stand there transfixed by the transfiguration?
或者是摩西只是在那儿变了相。站在那里，
I don't know.
我也不知道。
All I know is verse 30 says they spoke about Jesus' departure.
我所知道就是三十一节讲的谈论耶稣去世的事。
All I know is once more God is honoring his servant Moses by allowing him to see his glory.
我所能知道就是神再一次来让耶稣看到，让摩西看到他所服侍的主。
We are closing. Hear these last words.
我们马上要结束了。
Church, how much did God love his servant Moses that he protected him from birth, raised him in a palace, kept him for himself, appeared to him in a burning bush, personally carried him to his own death, and then brought him back to glorify the Son.
摩西是何神是何等的爱摩西，他在出生的时候就保护他，然后抚养他长大，然后带领他，最后让他也埋葬了他，又让他复活，看到了这位荣耀的救主。
As Deuteronomy 34:10 says, Moses was the only man who knew God face to face.
就像生命记三十 34:10
Church, how much did the Lord love the servant?
摩西是唯一跟神面对面的，所以神爱他的仆人。
Church, how much does God the Father love God the Son?
神父神爱 爱他的儿子是何等的圣洁呢？
We should meditate on that.
我们应该来好好思想这个事。
The perfect love and fellowship and communion between the Father, the Son, and the Spirit.
圣父、圣子、圣灵之间，他们有完美的爱，完美的。
How much does the Father love the Son?
父神爱圣子是何等。
The Father knows.
父神知道。
That the Son must go to the cross alone.
他知道他的儿子必须单独的上十字架。
The Father knows.
神知道。
There is no one like God the Son.
没有任何与神、
Amen?
儿子相比的。
God the Father knows.There is no one like God the Son.
父神知道没有人与圣子相比。
He knows that God the Son must die alone.
但是他知道他却要孤独地去。
For the sins of all mankind.
为着所有人的罪。
The best he can do.
他能做的最好的事。
He can send his servant.
他可以差遣他的仆人。
For his son.
去安慰他的儿子。
Amen.、
嗯
There was no servant like Moses.
没有能像摩西这样的仆人。
God looked around heaven and said, Moses, you got to go.
神看所有的在天堂的人说，摩西你必须。
God looked at Elijah and said, Elijah, you got to go.
跟以利亚说，你必须去。
I need you to go.
我需要你去。
I need you to go down there one time.
我需要你再去到那里。
My son deserves an audience.
我的儿子。要我我的儿子要有人去安慰他。
Amen.、
嗯、
My son deserves.
我的儿子
to be seen for who he is.
我的儿子配得让人看见他是谁。
And I choose you to go.
我选择你们去。
While you're there,
你们在那里的时候。
Do you remember how Joshua used to put his hand under your elbow?
你还记得约书亚如何把他的手放在他的肩？
Moses would have wept as he recalled Joshua holding his elbow up.
摩西在回想约书亚托住他的手的时候，他会哭泣。
And the father would have said, "I need you to do that for my son."
父神说，我也需要你对。
You were born as a baby. You lived as a man.
你生下来，你作为婴孩出生，但是你是一个成人儿。
I was there when you died.
当你死死亡
you go.
死的时候，我在那里。
Moses, you go.
摩西，你现在要去。
You go and you support and you pray and you encourage God the Son.
你需要去支持，要为这位神的儿子去祷告。
I don't know that all that happened.
我不知道这个是不是真的发生了。
But verse 30 says they talked about the journey.
但是三十一节确实是讲他。
And I can think of no one better.Than Moses,
我认为有任何比摩西更合适的
and Elijah
和以利亚
to be at the transfiguration of the Lord.
在主登山变相的时候，在那里。
Church,
弟兄姊妹们
how much does God the Father love you?
神何等的爱你们。
How much does God the Father love you?
父神是何等爱你。
If you are his servant,
如果你是他的仆人的话
he loves no one more than you.
他会非常的爱你。
He cannot love you more.
他会完全的爱你。
And he will not love you any less.
他也不会爱你更少。
For the servant of the king shows great love.
对于君王的仆人，君王是非常爱他们的。
Let Moses be our model this morning, one last time.
让摩西成为我们的榜样。
I can't imagine how Moses must have felt in all these moments. He and the Lord. I can't imagine.
我很难想象摩西在面对主的时候。他是如何感受的?
What I can say from my own experience,
从我自己的经历，我可以这样讲。
When I read God's word,
当我读神话的时候,
When I pray,
当我祷告的时候,
When I fellowship with saints,
当我和圣徒们相交的时候，
followers of God，
就是跟随主的人，
I feel the presence of God，
我能感到神的同在，
I feel the presence of God。
我能感受到神的同在。
Church，
弟兄姊妹，
God the Father loves us so much，
父神如此的爱我们，
that he sent God the Son，
他把他的儿子赐给我们，
the master servant，
他是一个仆人式的主人，
and the servant master，
也是仆人式的主人，
the king， the priest， the prophet，
的君王，祭司，先知，
the sacrifice， the lamb and the lion，
他是祭物，也是羔羊，也是狮子。
If you are not yet a Christian， hear me very carefully，
如果你还不是基督徒的话，你也要认真听。
Romans 10:9 says that if we confess with our mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in our hearts that God has raised him from the dead， we will be saved。
罗马书第十章第九节说，如果我们口里承认耶稣基督是主，心里相信他从死里复活，就必得救。
For those of you who have more questions than answers，
如果你还有很多问题的话，
you might be asking， Pastor Nate， what about the Old Testament？
你会问我说，这个旧约怎么讲？
Read Hebrews 11 and 12。
所以你要去读希伯来书十一和十二章。
Same salvation，
同样的救恩。
Same salvation，
讲的是同样的救恩。
Moses' salvation offered in the book of Deuteronomy is the same salvation offered by Christ in the New Testament。
摩西所讲的救恩，在生命之当中所讲的救恩，就是主耶稣基督在新约当中讲的主耶稣基督的救恩。
Repent and believe，
要悔改相信。
Trust and obey，
信靠顺服。
And no man is saved apart from the blood，
除了耶稣的血没人得救。
Repent and believe，
悔改相信。
Trust and obey，
信靠顺服。
And no man is saved apart from the blood，
除了耶稣基督的血以外没有人能得救。
Same message，
同样的信息。
Beloved，
弟兄姊妹们，
Jesus, the master of Moses and of all saints of God, he alone can save.
耶稣就是摩西的主，也是所有圣徒，神圣徒的主。
I encourage you this morning as we leave the book of Deuteronomy to meet the master in the same way that Moses met his master.
我鼓励在我们要结束生命记的学习的时候，你要自己亲自的去面对你的主。让我们一起祷告。
Holy God，
圣洁的天父，
You are holy and we are not，
你是圣洁的，我们却不是。
We are sinners，
我们是罪人。
We will not be saved at all if we will not be saved by you，
如果我们不是你拯救我们，我们无法得救。
Your servants understand that every good gift comes from above，
你的仆人明白一切美好的恩赐都是从上头来的。
By your gracious hand，
由你的恩手而赐的。
And we receive them even though we have no merit of our own，
我们虽然没有什么好处，但是我们仍然能够得到。
We receive them with trembling humble hands，
我们恐惧战惊的来接受你的礼物。
We receive them gratefully，
我们以感恩的心接纳。
Thankfully，
也感谢你。
Lord God， how great you are，
你是何等的伟大。
God the Father，
圣父啊，
Thank you for your love，
感谢你的爱。
Thank you for your plan，
感谢你的计划。
Thank you for your holiness，
感谢你的圣洁。
Thank you for your mercy，
感谢你的恩慈。
Lord Jesus，
主耶稣。
God the Son，
父神啊，圣子。
Thank you for being the perfect servant master，
感谢你成为一个完美的仆人式的主。
Born as a human，
你以人的形式
lived a perfect sinless life，
身为人活了一个没有罪的人生。
Died on a cross for the sins of humanity，
为人类的罪死在十字架上。
Rose from the grave 3 days later，
三天以后从死里复活。
Sits at the right hand of the Father，
坐在父神的右边。
Intercedes for all believers，
为所有信靠你的人代祷。
Holy Spirit，
圣灵啊，
Thank you，
感谢你。
Thank you for being comforter，
感谢你成为我们的安慰者。
Thank you for being present at the transfiguration of Christ.
感谢你在耶稣变相的时候你在那里。
And for guiding and revealing and empowering and comforting.
你来显明，你来指引，你来安慰。
Great revealer.
你是一个伟大的
life giver.
显明者，也是生命的赐予者。
Empower.
是大能。
God.
神。
Thank you.
感谢你。
In your name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.